We brought our friend Kena. She's here to help Taro.
The power of the mountain shrine is connected to everything in this forest. The trees here grew strong, drawing on its energy. And the land was once in perfect balance. But like all things, the mountain shrine follows a natural cycle. One that our village struggled to understand. As the shrine's power began to fade, a devastating famine struck our village. Taro lost his parents, and he was left to take care of Benny and Saya. I should have done more to help Taro. And now I can only watch as his spirit struggles.
We can still help Taro, Rusu. There's a relic covered by the corruption at your house. But I need a way to break through.
That weapon you carry, I sense it holds a deeper power.
The staff belonged to my father. It's been in our family for generations.
He must have been a great spirit guide. I may be powerless against the corruption, but I can teach you a new way to fight it back. To a trained archer, the bow is simply an extension of the body. A spirit guide staff is no different. Ground yourself. Feel the energy of the mountain. Draw on its power. Try using your bow on these targets. When you are finished, feel free to practice at the other stations I've set up.
Wow, great shot!
Woohoo!
Can you pick that up?
Focus is critical. Fully draw the bow, and your arrows will be more powerful. Pull the lever to drop the targets. See if you can hit them before they reset.
All right.
Wow, great shot!
You'll need to move quickly for this one. Follow the path and hit all six targets before time runs out. Ready? Go! Here, you'll need to make every shot count. Destroy all the targets to progress. There are 3 difficulty levels. Painted whirlybird to begin. Aim quickly and hit them all in the air. Manifestations of corruption patrol the path ahead. Your bow should help clear the way.
Thank you.
This broken path leads to my house. The corruption there is powerful. Be careful, Kena.
Thank you.
that knife for Taro when he was a boy. He loved these woods. And I tried my best to teach him the old ways. Consumed by the troubles of our village. I was not there for Taro when he needed me most. I hope we can bring him peace. More relics are hidden in the corruption of the Forgotten Forest. I'll wait for you there.
Thank you.
Good to be back.
Yeah, I wish Taro was here.
Pick that up?
Thank you. Come on. Right there. All right. Right over there.
Yeah.
reveals the true age of these shrines. The people who built them have long been forgotten, but their work still remains. Watching over the forest like ancient guardians, Taro's spirit has corrupted the shrines and sealed the entrance to the guardian tree. I can feel Taro's presence there. I've marked the shrine locations on your map.
Thank you, Rusu. I'll work to clean the shrines.
Can you pick that up?
Thank you.
were built on places of power. Their stones are buried deep, connected to the flow of energy beneath the ground.
Can you move that for me?
Right over there. Go. It's over there. Right over there. Right there.
Children and Taro often fished in these streams, in the stillness of the forest.
Taro and his siblings felt safe in these woods. You taught them well, Rusu. There are several worn fishing baskets here. A simple design, but effective.
Thank you.
Some believe the shrines represent guardians of the forest. From up here, it's easy to imagine them watching over the land. We leave offerings at the Guardian Tree, asking it to protect the ones we love. Taro left this for the children. He must have been so scared when he lost them. Many of the offerings here were placed by the first village leaders. Skilled hunters who use spirit energy to create powerful weapons. I'm sure the Guardian Tree won't mind if we use them to help Taro. Corruption waits for you in the Lantern Cave, but I suspect Taro's spirit will fight to the end.
fox symbol is marked on this old camping gear.
Thank you.
Taro's lantern. He must have lost it searching for the children.
Bring the relics to the fallen tree. It's time to help Taro find peace.
I'm going to help Taro now, but it's not safe for you here. Go with Mr. Rusu. I'll find you when Taro is free.
Be careful, Kana.
Thank you. The sickness that took our parents was spreading through the village.
Spirits of the forest, walk with our people. Guide them on their journey to the mountain shrine.
Food was running low. Everyone was scared. I never felt so helpless. Saya wanted to stay, but I thought we could go to Rusu for help. I was sure he would know what to do. But something was not right in the woods. I had never seen Rusu so worried. He sent us back to the village. And I knew we were alone. I was all that Benny and Saya had left. I had to protect them. It happened the next morning. From the mountain shrine covered the land in darkness.
Oh no! No! Benny! Saya! Where are you?
It lasted for days. I searched everywhere for them. I was their older brother. I was supposed to protect them. Even now, it's hard to forgive myself.
Taro, the children know how much you care for them. What happened in the village wasn't your fault. You will always be their older brother, and they still need you.
I'm sorry, Kena. We can't take you to the mountain shrine.
It's okay. You have to go now.